रेडी? बाय द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द सीबीएसई बोर्ड ऑनलाइन क्लासेस विल बी स्टार्टेड बाय अवर इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड अकॉर्डिंगली आई विल ऑल्सो स्टार्ट अबाउट द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस बिफोर फॉर द हेल्प ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 9 एंड स्टैंडर्ड 10 स्टूडेंट. टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू डील or describe about the chapter from the social science as a part of history, term 1, chapter 1, called the age of industrialization. This chapter indicates about the matter concerned to the industrialization which began in Europe, especially in England. In England, where the industrialization will be started by the 3 or 4 phases. Phase of industrialization also described by the historians for the better understanding about the age of industrialization. Accordingly, this chapter indicates about the outlook of the industrialization over the world. And world industrialization indicate about the matter of the growth of manufacturing from the world, especially in England, by the way of different type of the simple and the large machines. This chapter indicate about the matter concerned to the age of industrialization. According to that, it's subdivided between the 4 groups. First stage about the age of industrialization indicate before 17th century, usually called the pre-industrialization. Those will be started from England as well as the Europe before 17th century. And second phase of industrialization will be started before 18th century. Third phase of it was also called proto-industrialization. Next to the before 19th century and during 18th century, industrialization began in England as well as the Europe. Today, as recently after 19th century, 20th and 21st century indicate about the industrial capitalism. It is quite essential to the student of standard 10 to understand about the first one as pre-industrialization. Pre-industrialization were the period when the people trying to overcome about the production and the management with the help of the hand labor. Hand labor concerned to the England as well as the Europe carried out the function with the help of the old methods of the products. Some about the features of the pre-industrialization where first one handmade production. Second one, production based on human skills. And third one, production only for consumption due to the low production, low investment. Next to the proto-industrialization where the period which will be started before 18th century when over the country different type of the intricate design will be manufactured and after that finished to the central town of London. London is a finishing center, was the finishing center where all about the manufacturing product will be finished and after that domestically circulated. Some about the features of the proto-industrialization where first, as about the production or the manufacturing based on the simple machine. production and manufacturing based on the simple machine. Second one, production and manufacturing with the help of the small investment. Third one, intricate design and domestic exchange due to the simple machine based system of production and management. Third period indicate as industrialization during 18th and 19th century from England as well as the Europe. Accordingly, some about the features were there. First one, production or the manufacturing in England and Europe based on the heavy machine and heavy investment. Bulk production and uniform design due to one roof and management where the production and manufacturing will be carried out. Human skill and technical work are also required with the non-technical also due to the too much investment and uniform production as bulk as well as the large for the international exchange. After that today, as a period after the 19th century, during 20th and 21st century, as recently the period who describe as imagined by historian and before 19th century as about the industrial capitalism. It defined as individual decision making. Some about the features from the period as recently individualism, capitalistic system of administration, too much monopoly of MNC, profit maximization, and international exchange through the immigration and others way of the globalization. Now, this chapter also indicates about the production with the help of the pre-industrialization period, proto-industrialization period, industrialization and the industrial capitalism. Then after industrialization, in Britain, related description given as chapter 1. In the Britain or England, where the industrialization will be started due to the three reasons. First one, the skillful production and the management. Second one, availability of raw and ready material. Third one, the risk of entrepreneurs led the way of the pre, proto and the industrialization in England as well as the Britain, as well as the Europe. So that in Europe, where the industrialization carried out with the help of the simple machine. Proto-industrialization referred above the forwarded to industrialization with the help of the simple machine. Simple machine concerned to the production will be arranged over the Europe as well as the especially in England, and those will be finished at the center of London. So London became as a finishing center during proto-industrialization. After that industrialization take place, and accordingly heavy machine and technology will be used instead of fly shuttle, instead of the simple machine. Now, factory system began in England. Those will be emerged with the help of the Richard Arkwright. Richard Arkwright was one of the entrepreneur who trying to overcome about the problem of England and Europe with the help of the cotton production in Manchester. Manchester is one of the place from England where the first cotton production carried out by Richard Arkwright, the entrepreneur, in 1730. And after that, those will be multiplied. Next to the industries which set up in England after the cotton, called iron and steel. Metal industry from Scott. So, cotton and metal became the growing industry as a factory system will be started from England as well as the whole over the Europe. Now, some about the other features also given as about during industrialization, how EIC control over the British landscape, those will be carried out by the one-way trade policy, by the removal of the existing traders, and different type of the other way of the production with the help of European managing agencies. Other facts also given as next to the topic as peculiarities of industrial growth. Industrial growth became peculiar in England as well as the whole over the Europe and the world by the different way. Traditional industry will be converted to the modern one. Handmade production will be converted to the machine-made production. Unskilled manpower will be replaced to the skilled manpower. Domestic exchange of the goods and services will be replaced to the international. And domestic marketing system also convert to the international marketing system. In this way, new system of the production and management will be emerged with the help of the new innovation of the machine and technology. Machine and technology led the way of the production and management with the help of the new innovation, likely to the James Watt. Newcomen and Matthew Boulton combined led the way of the innovation of steam power, steam engine, and accordingly, who trying to overcome about the problem of the power related requirement. Next to the topic also given as hand labor and steam power, there are the two way. Hand labor indicate about the pre and proto industrialization when traditional system of the management carried out. Traditional system of the production carried out. But machine based system, steam power indicate about the mechanized production accordingly. Machine-based production led the way and overcome about the market and about the uniform variety of goods and services. So hand labor replaced through the steam power, those led the way of the miserable condition of the traders, workers, weavers and other people who belongs to the lower section of the society in England as well as the Europe. Reasons for the miserable condition of the small traders, workers, weavers and others led the casual workers and others led the way due to the different reasons. First one about the emergence of heavy industries. Heavy industries led the way of a stiff competition between handmade and machine-made production. Handmade and machine-made production led the problems concern to the handmade production became intricate design and substandard, but machine-made production became as a standard and uniform. Handmade production became as a precious, high cost to those who became as sale as a high cost of the product due to cost of production, too much cost of production, and machine-made product as cheap as possible. So that some about the other reason behind the miserable condition of the small traders to the influence of the trade guilds, big businessmen, big entrepreneurs and the traders who overcome the market of England as well as the Europe. Next to the handmade production led the stagnant or slow progressive due to those overcome by the machine-made production. So some about the other also cause concern to the miserable condition of weavers, workers and others led the way due to the appointment of the Gomastha as to the control of weaving products. Industrialization in colony will be carried out especially in India. India is a colony of Europe. Here the industrialization also carried out with the help of some about the way. First one, as pre-industrialization in India will be started from Bombay, Madras and Kolkata as a presidency town. After that, proto-industrialization will be started in India from the Madras, Bombay and Kolkata also, and finishing center became at Bombay. Now, industrialization also started from Bombay as 1854, first cotton mill will be start the way. And those carried out the production in 1956. In 1955, first jute mill will be set up in Kolkata and next to the, in 1854, first cotton mill will be started from Bombay. 1855, first jute mill also started in Kolkata. And in 1871 and others, when the different type of the weaving and the knitting mills will be established so that cotton and silk led the way of the factory system in India. So factory system in India will begin with the European Managing Agency. Three European Managing Agency led the way of the factory system in India to overcome the Indian entrepreneurs. Indian entrepreneurs trying to overcome about the problems of the production and management in India, like Dinsa Petit from Bombay, Dwarkanath Tagore, Seth Hukumchand, Jane Tata, G.D. Birla and other entrepreneurs trying to establish the production and management in India with the help of the high risk policy. Those will be invest the shares with the help of the China trade, and after that who led the way of the risk with the help of the factory system in India. Those will be overcome by the European Managing Agency, three European Managing Agency who came to India to overcome the Indian entrepreneurs. First one, Bird Hazlers and Company. Second one, Andrew Yule and Company. And third one, Jardine Skinner and Company. So that three company who became a joint stock company who came to India and trying to overcome the Indian market as monopolistic way of the trade and commerce. After that, the factory system will be multiplied. And next to the topic indicate where did the workers came from. The workers came from the district around where the factory will be started. Concern to the district around workers came from. Better example, in Bombay, where the close to the Ratnagiri district, where the workers came from Ratnagiri district, Dharavi and others, slum town, where the different type of the too much population who became as a workers. In the Kanpur, where workers came from the countryside, in the Kolkata, Bihar, Bengal and Odisha, concerned to the workers came from. Next to the topic indicate, why Manchester goods came to India? Manchester goods came to India due to the one-way trade policy of the British government. Henry Partulow, the British officials who realized about the better market condition in India and those control over the finished product export from India and free the finished product import in India. So that who trying to overcome about the problems concerned to the existing traders and Manchester cotton products came to India and raw cotton will be sent to the England. After that, next topic also indicate why a small scale industry predominate in India. A small scale industry predominate in India during First World War, when England and France became busy with the war need, then in India, here the market became vacant and a small scale industry became predominant by the risk associated work of the Indian entrepreneurs. Next to the topic also indicate about the industrialization in India concerned to the position of the workers, weavers and others. Those will be referred about the miserable condition of Indian workers because Indian workers suffered from the fate of a stiff competition between handmade product as well as the machine-made product. One-way trade policy of the British government, colonial government, and other way led the way of the miserable condition of Indian workers as well as the weavers. Next to the beginning of industrial revolution in England or Europe, concerned to the region behind, given as last one about the topic who indicate about the market for the goods. Market for the goods led the way by the three ways. First one, written and oral advertisement. Second one, different type of the labels likely to the made in Manchester, made in India and others. And third one, images or the pictures of the god, goddesses and royal king or the monarch led the way of the challenging of the goods and services, and those led the way of marketing for goods. Some about the question concerned to the chapter likely to the features of the pre-industrialization. Features of the proto-industrialization. Features of industrialization. Some about the main features of the period of industrial capitalism. What were the peculiarities of industrial growth? Why a small scale industry predominate in India? Why Manchester goods came to India? What were the position of the workers, weavers and small traders in India and England? How the Manchester goods came to India and what are the way of the marketing of goods and services. That's all. Thank you.